Chris Rock had a saying. He said, why is the most violent street in every neighborhood is named for the man that stood for nonviolence? And when I was a kid, a young man in my 20s, I decided to move on to Martin Luther King Boulevard in Newark. Now, the cynical joke nature is actually Martin Luther King Boulevard in the 90s had some really great sections, but the section I moved on to it did have a lot of violence and a lot of challenges. I tell you, I was overwhelmed by what I saw, but what was more interesting to me was the people I met in my first days living in our state's largest city. And one of the people I met was this woman. She was 5 foot and a smidgen. She was the tenant leader of Brick Tower, some buildings I ended up moving into for 8 years. Was the last person to leave that public housing before we demolished it and started to build anew in that neighborhood. And Miss Jones, I met her, was a little overwhelmed by what I saw, but I was still a little big for my britches, as my dad would say, and I said, ma'am, I'm Cory Booker. I just moved in the neighborhood. I'm still a law student, and I'm here to help you. And she looked at me like, you want to help me? She looked at me like, young man, you need some help. But she said, okay, we can try this. And she said, okay, if you want to help me, follow me. And she walks me right in the middle of Martin Luther King Boulevard. And I'm not exaggerating. We stood on the yellow line on this big boulevard in Newark as cars were walking back and forth. And she said, if you want to help me, you got to first tell me what you see in this neighborhood. And I looked at her, I go, what do you mean? She goes, tell me what you see. And I said, okay, I see a narcotics trade going on down there, ma'am. I said, I see an abandoned building over here, and I see some graffiti. I just described what I saw. And the more I talked, the more upset and disappointed this woman looked. And finally she said, you can't help me. And she turns around and walks away. And I run after her. I stop her on the side of the road, and I say, what are you talking about? I don't understand. Why can't I help you? And she looks at me hard. Now remember, I'm 6'3", she's 5 foot in a smidgen, but at this moment, I look like she's looking down on me, and she says these words I'll never forget. She says, boy, if you want to help me, you got to understand something. That the world you see outside of you is a reflection of what you see, what you have inside of you. And if you're one of those people who only sees problems and darkness and despair, that's all there's ever going to be. But if you're one of those stubborn people who every time you open your eyes, you see hope, possibility, you see love, you see the face of God, then you can be one of those people that helps me.
Tomorrow is our chance to prove the pundits wrong. In the heat of August, on an untraditional day, I want to know, are you all going to come out to vote? Can I count on you to vote? Are you going to bring somebody with you? Are you going to tell all the pundits you're wrong? Are we going to move this state forward? Are we going to make Washington work again? Are we going to do it together?